Hello children, you have already learned about some geometrical figures and shapes in your earlier classes, is it? Now in this lesson you will learn how to make accurate drawings of some of them, okay? And the main topic of this lesson we are going to study is constructions using ruler and compass. You already know what is a ruler. Ruler means what? Our scale. And you know that it is used to measure or draw line segments, etc. Okay? And what is the next one? Constructions using ruler and compass. Compass means what? This is compass. Look at this. This is compass. You know that it has a pointer on one end and there is a provision for pencil on the other end. And it is used to draw circles, to draw arc, to mark equal length, etc. Okay? So the first topic we are going to study in this lesson is construction of circle. We already studied circle, radius, what is radius, everything. Okay? Now the first topic you have to learn here in this lesson is construction of a circle when its radius is known. What is the radius, children? Radius we already studied in our previous chapters. A line segment drawn from center to any point on the circle is the radius, is it? So we have to, in this lesson, you have to construct a circle when its radius is known. Now, how will you construct a circle? Now, what is the first question? Draw a circle of radius 3 cm. Now, listen children, for constructing a circle, if its radius is known, the first step is, what is step 1? You have to mark a point. First, you mark a point. Either you mark it in the middle of the page, okay? Mark a point with a sharp pencil. And this is the center of the circle, okay? Mark a point with a sharp pencil and just give one name, O. Point O. Okay, so what is the first step? First step, you have to mark a point with a sharp pencil and just give one name to that point, okay? And the second step, listen everyone, the second step is that you have to take a scale and compass, okay? And what is the radius here? What is the radius in this question? Radius is 3 cm, okay? Now do one thing, place the pointer of the compass. Listen children, place the pointer of the compass at 0 mark of the ruler. Place the pointer at the 0 mark of the ruler. And open the pencil point so that it reaches 3 cm. Okay? So that it reaches 3 cm. Pointer of the compass at the 0 mark of the ruler. And open the pencil point so that it reaches 3 cm in your ruler. Okay? 3 cm mark. And after taking the measure, be careful children, don't change your compass measure. So this is 3 cm. 3 cm, okay? After taking the measure, don't change your compass measure. If I am drawing like this way, it will be a small figure. So you take the correct measure. Pointer of the compass at the 0 mark of the compass, 0 mark of the ruler. And open the pencil point so that it reaches 3 cm mark in your ruler. Okay? And what is the third step, children? Place the pointer of the compass here. Place the pointer of the compass at this point. Pointer of the compass on this point and just turn slowly to draw a circle. I hope it's clear. What is the next step? Place the pointer of the compass here and just turn slowly to draw a circle. Okay? Just turn slowly to draw a circle. Draw a circle, okay? So this is the required circle of radius 3 cm. From center to, if there is any doubt, you just measure it. This will be 3 cm, okay? This will be 3 cm. I hope this first question is clear. What is our question? Draw a circle of radius 3 cm. What is the first step, children? First, you have to mark a point. Mark a dark point. And name any letter you can name, okay? With a sharp pencil, you mark a point. What is the second step? place the take your scale, take your ruler and your compass, and place the pointer of the compass at the zero mark of the ruler, and open the pencil point so that it reaches 3 centimeter mark. Okay, and what is the next step? So the distance between the pointer and the pencil is now 3 centimeter. This distance is 3 centimeter. After taking the measure, don't change your compass measure, okay? And you place the pointer of the compass here. Place the pointer of the compass here and just turn the compass to draw a circle, okay? So you will get the required circle. I hope this question is clear. Practice it. Now move to the second question. Now, what is the second question? With the same center O, draw 2 circles of radii, 4 centimeter and 2.5 centimeter. Now, here you have to construct 2 circles with the same center O. With the same center, you need to construct 2 circles. Okay. Now, how will you do this construction? For constructing a circle, listen, children. If the radius is given, for constructing a circle, the first step is that you have to mark a point. Mark a point. And here already the name is given, the center as O. First you have to mark a point. Now what is the second step? Take your ruler and take your compass. And what is the first radius given here? First radius is 4 centimeter. Okay. First radius given at is 4 centimeter. Now do one thing. Place the pointer of the compass at the zero mark. And pointer, listen children, pointer of the compass. Pointer of the compass at the zero mark of the ruler and open the pencil points, extends it, reaches at 4 centimeter. Okay, 4 centimeter mark. I hope it's clear. So, place the pointer of the compass at the zero mark of the ruler and just open the pencil points so that it reaches 4 centimeter. Okay, and what is the next step? Place the, without changing the compass measure. Now listen children, now the distance between this pointer and the pencil point is now 4 centimeter. Okay, now place the pointer of the compass here and just turn the compass to draw a circle. I hope it's clear. Just turn the compass to draw a circle. Place the pointer of the compass at the zero mark and just turn the compass to draw a circle. Okay. I hope it's clear now. Okay. So that means this distance from center to any point on the circle, this will be 4 centimeter. This will be 4 centimeter. Okay. I hope the first part is clear. And what is the second radius given here? It is 2.5 centimeter. Now the same thing, place the pointer of the compass at the zero mark of your ruler and extend. Open the pencil point so that it reaches 2.5 centimeter. Okay, 2.5 centimeter, 2.5 centimeter, 2.5 centimeter. Pointer here, 2.5 centimeter. And what is the next step? So always be careful, take the measure correctly by using your ruler and compass. Okay. So that means this distance from pointer to the pencil point, now the distance is 2.5. This distance is 2.5. Okay. Now what is the next step? Place the pointer of the compass here and without changing the compass measure, just draw a circle. Okay. Just turn the compass, you will get the correct circle. Okay, children. So this measure, from center to this measure, this will be 2.5 centimeter. I hope it's clear. From center to this, This is the radius from center to any point. The line segment drawn from center to any point on the circle is the radius. So this will be 2.5 centimeter. I hope this question is clear. So move to the third question. So we are doing exercise 14.1 questions. Okay. Now what is the third question? Draw a circle and any two of its diameters. If you join ends of these diameters, what is the figure obtained? And what figure is obtained if the diameters are perpendicular to each other? So there are two questions in this question. What is the first part? Draw a circle. Draw any circle. You can take any convenient radius for drawing the circle. Okay. Now draw a circle and any two of its diameter. Diameter. What is the diameter, children? Diameter means what's the line segment passing through the center of the circle with 10 points on the circle. Okay. Line segment passing through the center with 10 points on the circle is called diameter. Okay. You know that if this is a circle. And if suppose this is center, if this is the center, line segment passing through the center with n points on the circle. This is the diameter. Okay. So this is the diameter. This is the diameter. Okay. This is the diameter. Now what is this question? You have to draw a circle. You have to draw a circle with any radius. That means simply first you mark a point. The first part you mark a point, just name it as O. Mark a point and name it as O. With any radius, children, with any radius you draw a circle. With any radius you draw a circle. With any radius you draw a circle. Now what is the next step? What is the next step? If you join ends of these diameters, what is the figure obtained? If you and any two of its diameters, you have to draw two diameters. So first I am drawing the diameter. I am giving this letter O here. So first I will draw the diameter like this way. This is the diameter. Is it by using your scale you draw a diameter? This is the diameter. N points here and it is passing through the center of the circle. Okay. This is the diameter and another diameter I am drawing like this way. Another diameter I am drawing like this way. So this is also a diameter. Okay. So we already drew two diameters. And what is the next part? If you join the ends of these diameters, ends, this is one end, this is one end, this is one end, this is one end, and this is one end. If you join this, what is the figure obtained? So just join this end points by using your scale, you just join it. This one. Just join this. Just join this and just give a name A, B, C, D. And what is the question? What figure is obtained? What is the shape of this ABCD? You can see that here this side and this side are equal. AB and DC are equal. Like the same way this side and this side are equal. So opposite sides are equal here and the angle here it is 90 degree. So what type of figure is it? ABCD is a rectangle. ABCD is a rectangle. Here opposite sides are equal and the angles are 90 degree. So what you can say, ABCD is a rectangle. So we completed the first part of the question. Now what is second part? What figure is obtained if the diameters are perpendicular to each other? We already studied what is perpendicular. Perpendicular means what? Two lines or rays or line segments are said to be perpendicular if they intersect at right angles, or you can say the angle between them is 90 degree. So first you have to draw a circle. First, you draw a circle with any radius. Before that, you mark a point. Mark a point and just draw a circle. Okay? Draw a circle with any radius. Any convenient radius, you draw a circle. Okay? Any convenient radius, you draw a circle. Any convenient radius, you draw a circle. And what is the next step? Any convenient radius, you draw a circle. And what is the next step? If you join and draw two diameters perpendicular to each other. So, we will draw the diameters. Perpendicular diameters we need. So, one diameter and second diameter. Okay? Second diameter. And you can see that this angle is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree. So, these two line segments are perpendicular to each other. Now, if you join this ends, what figure you will get? If you join this ends, this end, and just join it and just give a name PQRS. Now look at this figure, children. You can see that here all the sides are equal. All these length PQ, QR, RS, PS, all the sides is having same length. And we know that here angle P is 90 degree, angle Q is 90 degree, angle R is 90 degree and angle S is 90 degree. So what type of figure is it, children? We can see that PQRS is a square. Here all the sides are equal and angle is 90 degree. We can say that PQRS is a square. So if the diameters are perpendicular to each other, you will get a square. If we are simply we are drawing two diameters and join it, you will get the shape of a rectangle. I hope this answers are clear. Do the remaining questions of this exercise as homework, okay? Okay, children, now move to the next question. Exercise 14.5, question number 6. Draw a circle with center C and radius 3.4 centimeter. We already studied how to construct a circle when its radius is given, is it? So we have to draw a circle with center C. Center is given the center C and radius 3.4 centimeter. Draw any chord AB. Draw any chord AB. What do you mean by chord, children? You know that chord means what? It's a line segment joining any two points on the circle is called chord of a circle. So we have to draw a chord AB. Construct the perpendicular bisector. Construct the perpendicular bisector of AB and examine if it passes through the center. Passes through the C. Passes through the C means passes through the center. Okay. Now how will we draw construct this figure, children? Now what is the first step? You have to draw a circle with center C and radius 3.4 centimeter. Okay. Now do one thing for constructing a circle. What is the first step? You have to mark a point. First you have to mark a point with a sharp pencil. And it is already given the center, you mark it as C. So we are naming it as C. And radius 3.4. So do one thing. The same step. Place the pointer of the compass at the zero mark. Opens the pencil point so that it reaches 3.4 centimeter. 3.4 centimeter. Okay. 3.4 centimeter. So the distance between this pointer and the pencil point now is a 3.4 centimeter. Okay. So draw a circle with center C and radius 3.4 centimeter. First you have to mark a point. Then take your compass and your ruler. Place the pointer of the compass at zero mark and opens the pencil point so that it reaches 3.4 centimeter. Okay. So that means the distance between the pointer and the pencil point is now 3.4 centimeter. Now be careful, children. After taking this measure, don't change this compass compass mesh. Okay, now you place the pointer of the compass here, pointer of the compass at the center, and just draw a circle. Okay, so here it will be a small circle, so I'm taking a big radius and drawing a big circle. Okay, you take the correct radius and draw the figure. Okay, so 3.4 centimeter radius, 3.4 centimeter, you draw a circle, draw a circle. Okay, so this will be 3.4 centimeter, 3.4 centimeter. Okay, from center to any point on the circle, from line segment drawn from center to any point on the circle is the radius. Now here the required radius is 3.4 centimeter. So what is the first step for constructing a circle? Mark a point and take 3.4 centimeter in your compass and place the pointer of the compass at the center point and just turn the compass. You will get the required circle of radius 3.4 centimeter. I hope up to this is clear for everyone. Now move to the next part of the question. Draw any chord AB. Chord AB, we know that what is a chord, children? It's a line segment joining any two points on the circle. So this is a chord, line segment joining any two points on the circle. And what is the name given here? Chord AB. So we can give it as A and B. I hope this is clear. Chord AB. Okay. Now what is the next step? Construct the perpendicular bisector of AB. Perpendicular bisector means what? What is perpendicular bisector? A line or a ray or line segment which is perpendicular to a given line segment and divides it into two equal halves is called the perpendicular bisector of the given line segment. That means suppose this is a line segment. Perpendicular bisector means what? Suppose this is the midpoint of this line segment, passing through the midpoint, and the angle between here it is 90 degrees. So we can say that this line is the perpendicular bisector of this particular line segment. Okay, perpendicular line bisector means what? It is perpendicular and dividing this line segment into two equal parts. Okay, so perpendicular bisector means a line or ray or line segment which is perpendicular to a given line segment. This is perpendicular and also divides it into two equal halves. This is this length and this length is same. So we can say that this line is the perpendicular bisector of this particular line segment. We already studied this in your previous earlier lessons, is it? So now we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of this chord AB. Now listen children, the important topic of this lesson is how to draw the perpendicular bisector. Listen everyone, for drawing the perpendicular bisector, the first step is that you know that this is a line segment. This is a line segment. From here to here, this is a line segment. Line segment means what? It has a definite length. We can measure the line segment. So what you have to, for drawing the perpendicular bisector, what you have to do is place the pointer of the compass at this point and take a measure. The radius of the compass will be more than half of this line segment. More than half of this line segment. Take more than half. This line segment, maybe this will be the middle point, more than half of this line segment. Take a measure, more than half of this line segment. More than half of this line segment. And draw one arc on either side of the line segment. Here one arc and here one arc. Okay. And after drawing the arc, don't change your compass measure. Without changing the compass measure, place the pointer of the compass on other end and just cut one more arc here and here. Okay, so what is the first step for drawing the perpendicular bisector? What you have to do children? First you have to place the pointer of the compass here and take the radius. That means take the measure more than half of this length of the line segment. More than half of the length of AB. That means more than half of the line segment. length of line segment and cut one arc here and cut one arc here, and without changing the compass measure, place it over here, cut the arc here, this side and this side, and after this mark the intersecting point of the arc. And by using your ruler, draw a straight line. Is it passing through the center? Yes, this line is passing through the center. So what is the answer? Examine if it passes through the center. Yes, it is passing through the center. C. I hope this is clear. For drawing the perpendicular bisector, what do you have to do here, children? After drawing the chord, place the pointer of the compass on one end and take more than half of this line segment AB. Draw an arc this side and this side. Without changing the compass measure, place the pointer of the compass on other end and cut the previous arc. Okay, and mark the intersecting point of the arc and just join it by using your ruler, and you can see that this line will be passing through the center. I hope this answer is clear for everyone. Now suppose if there are two chords, suppose one more chord if you are drawing. Suppose if I am drawing one more chord and if I am drawing the perpendicular bisector of this chord, how will we draw the perpendicular bisector of this chord? Suppose I am drawing one more chord. And I am drawing the perpendicular bisector of this chord. What will happen? How to draw a perpendicular bisector of the given chord? I am giving this name as E and F. Okay? E and F. So how will we draw the perpendicular bisector? Place the pointer of the compass on one end of the line segment. And take, this is our line segment. EF is our line segment. Place the pointer of the compass here and take a measure more than half of the, that means radius is more than half of the length of this line segment, and cut one arc here on either side of the line segment, and without changing the compass measure, just cut the previous arc. And mark the intersecting point of the arc. And by using your ruler, just join it, children. Just join the intersecting point. So you can see that this also is passing through the center. Okay, so what you can say that the perpendicular bisector of the first chord and the perpendicular bisector of the second chord is meeting at the center C. Both the perpendicular bisectors are meeting at the center C. This type of question is question number 8. So practice it by yourself. So what is the first step? You have to draw a circle. I'm telling you one more time. What is the first step? 8th question. You have to mark a point. And what name? If the name is given there in the question, you write the same name. Okay, then what is the next step? How will you construct a circle? Take, if the radius is 4 cm, take 4 cm in your compass and just draw a circle. Okay, 4 cm in your compass and draw a circle. And you have to draw two chords in that question. So you draw the first chord and draw the perpendicular bisector, and you draw one more chord and you draw the perpendicular bisector. You can see that both the perpendicular bisectors are meeting at the center C. Okay, so try to do it by yourself, it will be more clear for you. I hope these topics are clear. And quest number, exercise 14.5, quest number 8, you do it as homework. Quest number 8 and 7, you do it as homework. 8 and 7, you do it as homework. Quest number 8, the same type figure you will get. There, the radius is not 3.4 cm. In that question, the radius is 4 cm. You draw the circle and draw two chords and draw the perpendicular bisector. You will get the figure like this. That means both the perpendicular bisectors are meeting at the center C. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.